That's always a contest of, because they're both going to cool, so you got to eat them both at the same time. But I usually start with the cereal and move to the egg if the egg's too hot. So every day, I pretty much make the same breakfast. And what it's going to be is it's going to be Scottish oats with soy milk, regular milk, two kinds of fruit, one being usually banana, and then also eggs, four eggs, two of the yolks taken out, and fresh squeezed orange juice. Okay, so the first thing is, the reason I like Scottish oats because it's like the whole grain, so versus like a normal oatmeal, it's actually, you're not getting the whole grains. And what we do is you start with, it's a 3-to-1 ratio. So that's about a half cup there. And then I'll put like four things of salt in. So that was a half a cup, and I gotta do a cup and a half of water. And this is really simple, you just microwave it, that's it. You put it in the microwave. I just put it at high for 5 minutes and 30 seconds. Hit start. And that should be enough time to work on other stuff. The more you cook, the more you kind of get down a rhythm, so you can kind of be doing like a couple things at one time. Our fruit of the day will be a kiwi and a banana. These will be the two fruits. Oranges, usually depending on the size, 3 will work for a tall glass. If you rub the refrigerator, it actually scrapes off, so you gotta be kind of careful. I got this Krupp squeezer, it's literally $30, and it's so simple to use. It takes 2 seconds to clean out. And basically, you just cut your orange in half, and you stick it on here and you press down. It's cheaper, it's fresher, and it's easy, and it lasts longer. So I don't understand why people buy oranges. It's good oranges. Okay, so let's start with the eggs. I go for 4 eggs, take 2 of the yolks out. Always do half yolks, because there's too many yolks aren't good for you, but some are good. But you can tell how fresh an egg is because the yolk will be firmer and brighter, and the white will be clearer. Try to beat them really good. The more you beat them, the fluffier they get. Okay. The microwave finished, but we're gonna leave it in the microwave. It's actually, because it's still kind of wet probably, but if you leave the door closed in the microwave, it'll just, so while we're continuing to cook, we just let it go and it'll actually continue to cook. Okay, now we cut our fruit. In LA, you can go to Chinatown or anywhere and get a stone here. It's like $4. And that's it, now you got a sharp knife, that's it. Here's our kiwi, which will peel. It's a good kiwi. And cut our banana. We could actually cut it right over the cereal, but we can also do it on our plate. Everyday breakfast. It's so good, why would you not want to do it, you know? I'll let that heat for a second. Here's the cereal. My dad eats it like that, but I need something in there, so. I usually do honey, maple syrup, and cinnamon. Not too much. Perfect consistency there. Okay, just put a little, this is saltless butter. A little butter, not too much. And for your pan, make sure you do not use Teflon because it's toxic. This pan is Calphalon. Technique here for cooking. You start like this. You go around. And you just keep going until there's no more liquid. Okay, so the liquid's down. Now I flip it to one side. While that's going, we can add our fruit to the cereal. I like to do half soy milk, so I can never decide. And then we do half regular milk. And someday they're gonna make that. Flip it. Okay, let it cook on the other side there. Egg should be done. So you can just put it on the plate like so. There's our egg. We got our egg. We got our juice. And we got our cereal, and we got our New York Times. Now we